Donald Trump is facing the greatest challenge to the survival of his political career we have ever seen. And what makes this critical and crucial is that it's not just affecting him, it's also directly hitting many of his top political friends and buddies and allies. And that's what makes this story real and not merely hypothetical like it was maybe a few months ago. For a long time now, people have been arguing that Donald Trump, based on a reading of the Constitution, could be banned from multiple states, banned from at least 5 or 6 states in terms of being able to be on the ballot in those states because he is a traitor to the country. Because of what he did on and in the run-up to J6, he is a traitor and insurrectionist, disloyal to the United States. He should be banned for life from seeking office in those former Civil War, Confederate states. But what we're seeing right now is two of Trump's clear friends, two of Trump's top friends, Madison Cawthorn and Marjorie Taylor Greene, are both being hit by those provisions, and their terror and their desire to link it to the idea that Donald Trump is also getting banned makes this a very, very big threat to Trump.
They're having to distract from this by saying, look, oh, these people are insurrectionists, because the only way that they're capable of actually being able to win votes is by using emotions and not logic. And so what's going on in North Carolina, Steve, is that they've actually filed a challenge against my candidacy with the North Carolina Board of Elections. I'm sure are you familiar with a gentleman named Mark Elias?
Oh, very much so. Very much so.
Yes.
This is
so
one of his tactics.
For anybody who's watching that doesn't know, Mark Elias was really the true quarterback and architect of the steal that happened in 2020. He is also the architect of a lot of these legal challenges that happened to good conservative bills that come out of state legislatures. Now, this guy who's been fired from his law firm with a Napoleon complex is now currently attacking me in my state, saying that I am incapable of holding office because of the 14th Amendment, something that hasn't been used since the Civil War and the Reconstruction era. And so now they've filed with the 14th Amendment with the North Carolina Board of Elections, and it's probably going to go to the North Carolina Supreme Court, which is a very liberal haven for the Democrats, to try and keep me off the ballot. And now this is only going to lead to one place. When you want to try and take the right of the people away to be able to vote for their elected official, I mean, this is going down a very dangerous path. But we filed a counterpunch lawsuit in federal court with a good Trump-appointed judge. So I genuinely believe we'll be able to win this. We'll be able to destroy this narrative and hopefully set a legal precedent that they can't start using this against everyone else. And now, obviously, I don't think they're just after me. Obviously, if they're able to keep me off the ballot in North Carolina because of this, Donald Trump will never be able to be president again because he won't be able to win North Carolina.
And now the progressives, the people that donate to dark money groups, you know, the 501c3s and the foundations, they've hired up some attorneys from New York who hate the people in my district and don't believe that they should have the right to elect who they want to send to Washington, which is me. I have overwhelming support in my district, and I'm so thankful for all of them. Well, now they filed a lawsuit because they're trying to rip my name off of the ballot and steal my district's ability to reelect me and send me back to Congress.
So you can see there, Cawthorn makes a direct connection. He says they are trying to remove me from the ballot, and they will do this to Donald Trump. This is not some hypothetical. They are banning me from the ballot. That is their goal, and they want to use the same provision to ban Donald Trump from running in states like North and South Carolina, as well as Georgia and Florida and other states. And if you ban Trump from any one of those states, he almost certainly loses the presidential election because he needs those Electoral College votes. And Marjorie Taylor Greene, although in that clip she keeps it focused purely on herself, has said that the clear goal is to ban her and then use that precedent to ban Trump. She literally says, if the Democrats are successful in kicking me off the ballot, then legal precedent is set to ban President Trump from running again in 2024. And so these top Republicans are absolutely terrified, and that's what makes this real. Remember, Marjorie Taylor Greene tried to have this case thrown out, this case that brings her to court to say, you are a traitor, you are an insurrectionist, you are not allowed to run. And she tried to argue the case was spurious, but the judge said, no, this is a serious enough case with enough of a chance that you and Donald Trump merit banning that we are going to go to trial. It says a federal judge cleared the way on Monday for a group of Georgia voters to move forward with legal efforts seeking to disqualify Representative Marjorie Taylor Greene from running for re-election to Congress, citing her role in the January 6th attack on the Capitol. The disqualification is based on a constitutional provision adopted after the Civil War that barred members of the Confederacy from holding office. It mirrors several other cases involving Republican members of Congress whose role leading up to and during the deadly riot have drawn intense criticism. Ms. Greene, 47, who is known for her unflinching loyalty to former President Donald J. Trump and her clashes with Democrats, has steadfastly denied that she aided and engaged the attack on the Capitol. Again, write a link to Trump. And people are saying the Madison Cawthorn trial, didn't he win that? But no, he didn't. He won an ability to have an injunction, but as this headline notes and as reporting notes, the case against him has been fully revived. That's not done yet. So you have two top Trump allies literally being taken to court to be banned from the ballot in their own state, and both of them admitting that this is a direct call to also ban Trump. Finally, even his pal Matt Gaetz has said this is obviously an attack on Trump. He says Florida Republican Matt Gaetz told Just the News that he thinks the House January 6th committee will try disqualifying former President Trump for running for president again. Quote, disqualifying potential candidates is the newest and most dangerous iteration of cancel culture, Gaetz said on Thursday. I believe the J6 committee is going to try to do it regarding Donald Trump. I believe some woke activists in North Carolina are trying to do it right now in a very important test case regarding Carolina Republican Madison Cawthorn. Right now, that's what we're looking at. Donald Trump is getting banned from multiple states. At least that's where the legal winds are blowing. Listen to people when they speak. If Marjorie Taylor Greene and Madison Cawthorn are on trial to be banned from the ballot and they say it's direct precedence to ban Trump, then Donald Trump is on trial to be banned from the ballot as well. And that'll end his career.